Hello guys, my name is Erik Stigio and today I want to show you how I made this painting of a goblin chilling with his beetle on the desert, and I will also discuss some concepts and the ideation for the whole painting, so I guess enjoy. Basically, the whole painting started in my digital painting classes at Domin Gdańsk in Poland, the school where I teach. When I was showing my students how you can approach creating some different illustrations and pretty much what to do if you have no idea how to start to make an illustration. And in this case, the whole process was like extremely easy because it started with some really like simple keywords of things that you find interesting. So in this case, I just wrote down something like a desert, a beetle, a goblin, and pretty much whatever, and tried to make some sort of a map of these words to just write down the things that I feel that are connected to my keywords. And after like having a lot of different keywords, I pretty much just took the most interesting ones and combined them together to create some sort of a really simple brief. So this way I was able to make some sketches, because I don't really like making sketches where I have no idea what to paint. I always like to have some sort of a purpose in the things that I'm doing. So I felt like instead of like just doing some random sketches, maybe I will just make myself some sort of a brief. And also this is one of the methods that I teach. And after having some brief, I have a way easier time painting pretty much anything, because if I know that I want to make some sketches for some, for example, in this case, beetles in the deserts or whatever, I can pinpoint what I want to focus on. I know what I need to study. I know what types of pictures I need to search for. And pretty much I just have way easier time sketching and concepting and doing pretty much everything, because if I have a solid brief to follow, or at least any brief to follow, like it will limit the possible outcomes from the sketches, and by limiting possible outcomes of the sketches, it will make my life easier to just paint a nice, I hope nice picture. So it's also one of the things that I really recommend to you guys. If you have no idea what to paint and you get stressed when you try to sketch something and nothing's really comes out from it, just try some writing or doing some like simpler stuff. Because in my opinion, like I believe I said it many times, I strongly believe if you can describe a painting or a picture in a like 2-3 sentences and it will sound cool, it's like an almost 100% chance it will also look cool if you will paint it. So in my opinion, like the description comes before like the painting itself. So this way it will be a little bit more interesting. Also, when doing some sort of a text before like painting, you can pretty much quickly see if it sounds original or if it sounds interesting. Because in this case, when I felt like the general idea was to make some sort of a guy like riding a mount on the desert, like it felt kind of basic. I also thought maybe I will make some sort of a dragon, so he is like going on the giant lizard or whatever, but I felt like I have seen this way too many times and it sounds just kind of basic in my opinion. So I felt like maybe changing the guy to the goblin will be interesting, because also like changing, like creating a goblin with this Middle Eastern like details on them, like with this clothing, like Arabic clothing or something, will be an interesting thing, because I strongly believe I have never seen this type of goblin like pretty much anywhere. So it was like a one point for this idea. And also I felt like I have not really seen a lot of different beetles being illustrated in the fantasy paintings, and they are really cool creatures, especially after like studying them for a while, because before jumping to this illustration I felt like I need to know a little bit more about the beetles. So I was just like watching some pictures, watching some quick documentaries and just sketching them quickly, so I have like a little bit better understanding of them. And also while painting, I discovered, or I reminded myself, that something like albino like beetles exist, and I felt maybe like making the white giant albino beetle that is a mount in the desert will be like a really interesting thing to see, because I have never seen something like this done before, and I just felt it will be okay. And for the whole painting, I think I failed a little bit with the white beetle part on the painting, because in this light scenario, in the end, in the final picture, it kind of looks way too black, in my opinion. I don't have problems with it, but I guess it just was not turning out how I wanted it to be. At the moment, it looks white, but yeah, in the final, I kind of lost it. While the painting, I got kind of distracted with all the different techniques and everything, and with the values. So I guess now at least I know what I need to study a little bit more to improve my skills. So now I know if I want to improve further, I need to study some painting, some white things in the background to not lose the white color. So yeah, it's also a nice thing to be able to do, just to admit to yourself that you cannot do something. It will make the whole process thing way quicker for you. And yeah, the whole video, if anyone is interested, is sped up by 27 times. The final painting, like from placing the sketch to the canvas to finishing it, took almost 5 hours. It was like a really quick painting in this case. And yeah, and for this one also, I tried to not use the photos for as long as possible. I tried to paint way more instead of like relying on photographs and everything. Just for the sake of painting, I just wanted to practice painting sand and to practice painting some colors. And I only have used the 2 or 3 photos in the end, just for the details on the foreground and in the midground, so the whole painting will look a little bit more interesting. And with the goblin, and for the sketches that I was showing previously at the beginning of the video, it was like something extremely simple. I just pretty much searched for some like oriental traditional paintings, like from previous ages or whatever, and just pretty much took some parts, combined them together, did some silhouettes, and tried to paint the whole goblin to give him like this a little bit more Arabic feel. And in this case also, you can see I decided to add a beard for the goblin, because I felt like this old goblin riding with his like companion on the desert will have like a stronger narrational impact. And also I had to change his cape to the blue color, because when he had this white beard and red hat and red cape, I kind of felt like he's looking like a Santa Claus. So I needed to change the whole cape for the color blue. And I also think it was like a good decision, because I already have like a plenty of red hues in the whole painting. So I felt like taking a blue color that is a complementary color to the red and oranges and yellows will make him pop a little bit more in the composition, but will also allow me to unify the goblin a little bit better with the white beetle, because I can imagine like the white color like reflecting the blue sky will be pretty much more bluish. So I thought like the blue goblin will make a little bit more sense. And to unify also the goblin with the beetle, or the beetle with its owner, I tried adding some like coins and some drapery on top of them, so they will have like a similar like details decorating them. So you can see some coins hanging from the face of the beetle, or you can see like some blue drapery hanging from the sides of the beetle. Also on top of the beetle there is a small hut for the goblin to sit in, so you can imagine the scale of these two guys a little bit better. And it's pretty much all in terms of this painting. Like, it's nothing crazy. In this case it was more like an experiment with a different technique, how to paint these guys and how to make them. Also I try to make this video a little bit more compact, so it's not like a 30 minutes long, so it will be like a 10 minutes long, so it will be a little bit easier to digest. And also one thing that I really wanted to add in this painting was some floating rocks. Like, recently I have a thing for floating rocks. I feel like they add a lot of cool details to the environment, so I guess a lot of next paintings that I will produce will have some floating structures or rocks in the environment, because I think they look cool. And in here I also tried to make some like simple quick sketches, just to see some details on the guy. and to make some really simple like logo design on his site. So for example, everybody will know this beetle comes from this village or pretty much whatever. And if you have any questions for this illustration or for anything in particular, feel free to ask. I will gladly reply to everything in the comments or maybe in the video. A lot of you guys have suggested a lot of different cool things for the future videos, so I guess I will start preparing all the videos like the topics you have suggested. And also, if you want me to make an overpaint for your paintings or for your stuff, just send them to my fan page at Facebook or to my email, that's typhonart@gmail.com. So yeah, I will make one episode or more episodes where I do an overpainting over your stuff, guys. So remember to like and subscribe and share or whatever, and I hope you learn something new and enjoy the video.